So for the pavlova, first of all, the important thing is the preparation of the tin. I use a tin that is a big, thick, old-fashioned tin. Here we are. And a nice heavy one that's absolutely flat. I then put a piece of non-stick silicone paper, which you can buy in rolls or on sheets, on top. This one I've used many times, and I'm just taking off the surplus sugar because I've used it, and you use it again and fold it up and keep it in the drawer. And then you want to mark, which I've already done because I've used it many times, mark an 8-inch circle, which you just do with a pencil around the outside. I'll do it more clearly. And that's ready to bake the pavlova on. If you use oiled paper, it isn't nearly as good, and it will free because Shelley was saying how hers stuck. Well, it doesn't stick if you use silicone paper. Then to the meringue part. Pavlova is Australian, and it differs from meringue because it has added corn flour and vinegar, and that makes it nice and soft and gooey in the middle, and that's the difference. Also, in the oven it does rise a little bit, whereas meringue stays exactly as when you've put it in. So first of all, separate the eggs. I'm using large ones, and separate the yolks from the whites, and then keep the yolks. You could make, if you wish, some lemon curd with the yolks if you wish, or you can make mayonnaise. In fact, that's what we're going to be doing on the programme next week, is making mayonnaise. There we are. Very carefully, making quite sure that you don't get any of the yolk in with the white. If you do, you must start again, because you mustn't have any fat in the bowl at all. And the third one. I know that I'm not given to testing eggs, but I do when it is for meringue, because you've got to be so, so careful. There we are. There's the yolks. And I can put the lid on and keep it for my mayonnaise, and keep it in the refrigerator. If you haven't got a nice little pot like this, you can always put a little bit of foil on top with a label so you don't get it muddled. You can also freeze the yolks if you wish, and add a little bit of sugar if you're going to use it for a sweet thing, and a little bit of salt if you're going to use it for a savoury thing. Now all the three whites are in the bowl, a nice clean shiny bowl, and then to stop it slipping about all over the place, put a cloth underneath and then whisk it. And I'm using a rotary whisk for this one, and you want to whisk it until it looks like a cloudy mixture. Now it's rather grey looking, or grey to yellow. Now get it to that stage. Whether you're using a hand whisk or a big mixing machine or a small electric whisk, you want to get it to that stage and then start adding the sugar. And you want to add the sugar just a little at a time, and then it will get stiffer and stiffer and stiffer. So a little like that, then go on beating. And then go on. And if you're using an electric mixer, a freestanding one, what I do is put it on full blast, and then I get it to this stage, then I add the sugar a little at a time as I walk past the machine, and perhaps I'll get on with the drying up and then put a little bit more on. But I stay in the kitchen, and it takes a good 10 minutes to go on whisking like this. But I'm not going to stay for 10 minutes doing this. I've already got some to this stage. There we are. So I will go on doing that a little bit later. I'll pop this underneath so I don't muddle the sugars. And I've got some here that I've already been whisking, and I've added almost all the sugar. I've just got a little bit more to add. So I'll put it on maximum. Add the last little bit of sugar. And then we come to the bit that makes it pavlova and not meringue. You want to get a teaspoonful of distilled vinegar, the white vinegar, the same one that we used for the toffee apples, and a teaspoonful of, just like that, of corn flour. Mix the two together. It's a bit like making custard, isn't it? Just mix them together, and then at the very end just stir it in. There we are. So that's all the ingredients in for the pavlova. It's really very, very easy up to this stage, isn't it? Free the beaters. and then scrape the mixture down. I'm going to give them a light bang on the side. Seems so strange not to have the children in the kitchen. I can never get past this. As soon as they hear they're in the door, and please can I lick one? I hope there's only two at a time, because there's only one each. There we are. That's the pavlova, looking very much like meringue. It is slightly more sloppy than it. It's nice and glossy. Put the mixture onto the circle that you've prepared. No greasing, because this is silicone paper. There we are. Take it all out of the bowl. That really could do with another little bit of a scrape. There we are. That's right, I'll put this underneath. Give me more room. Bet you wish you'd got a table like this at home that you can just tuck things away. It's a great help. So now you can see I haven't been too careful there, and I've just spilt it a little, so I'll just scrape that up. There's no grease in it, so I'll just press it up. Then spread this round like this. Now at the moment that's level, but you want to push it towards the side and make a rim all the way around the outside, so that you've got a hole in the middle to put a nice filling in. There we are. Now we've got it's rather deeper at the sides than it is in the middle. There we are. Then bake that, and you want to set the oven to 325 degrees Fahrenheit, gas number 3, and then when you put it in, turn it down to 300, number 2, and put it in the oven and bake it for 1 hour. And then when it's had its hour, you want to turn the oven off completely and let it get stone cold. And that's exactly what I've got in the oven right now. Now, I'm not taking oven gloves, because the oven is off and it's quite cold. There we are. Now you can see it swells rather. It's absolutely stone cold. There are no cracks on it, because it's been baked at exactly the right temperature. If you try to take it out of the oven without letting it cool in the oven, it will very likely crack. Take it off the paper, non-stick paper, it comes off very easily, and I will use that paper again. I'm going to put that on top of the cooker and then stand it on a stand. Always put it on what you're going to serve it on before you actually do it. Don't try and move it when it's filled. Then I've got some whipped cream here, half a pint. And you can add to that, lemon curd is very nice, homemade lemon curd that you could have made from the egg yolks. My mother does this, and it's something we like an awful lot in sponges or in pavlova. Or you can put some frozen raspberries that have just been thawed, because there are none at this time of the year. Just put those in, about 8 ounces. You can add sugar if you wish, but I don't really think there's any need to. And then just a quick stir and fill it. You want to fill it about an hour before you actually are going to eat it. So there we are. And it looks rather nice, and you can decorate it with fresh strawberries or raspberries.